Hello students, let's start this session with the lesson optics. In this lesson we are going to see sign convention, magnification of a lens, lens maker's formula, power of a lens and the difference between convex lens and concave lens. These are very important topics, so listen carefully. Let's see the important topic, sign convention. In the short video, you can see the converging lens, that means the convex lens is used to converge the light ray, and let's see what is meant by sign convention. First one, the object is placed on the left side of the lens. You can see here the object is placed at the left side of the lens. This is the left side of the lens. All the distance are measured from the optical center of the lens. This is the optical center, and all the distances are measured from the optical center, not at the curvatures. The distance measured in the same direction as that of the incident light are taken as positive. This side is taken as positive. The distance measured in the same direction is taken as positive. The distance measured against the direction of incident light is taken as negative. This side. The distance measured upward and perpendicular to the principal axis is taken as positive. The distance measured downward and perpendicular to the principal axis is taken as negative. These are the six important points in sign convention. Magnification of lens. See, nowadays we use the lens to magnify the objects. Like spherical mirrors, we have magnification for spherical lenses. Spherical lenses produce magnification, and it's also defined as the ratio of the height of the image to the height of an object. Magnification is denoted by the letter M. The magnification of lenses depends upon the ratio of the height of the object and to the height of an object. If the height of the object is h, then the height of the image is h dash. The magnification produced by a lens is, you can see what the magnification cause. This is one object, and using this magnification you can magnify the object into such a big image. Now M is equal to, that means the magnification of lens M is equal to height of the image divided by height of the object, which is H dash by H. Also it is related to the distance of the object U and the distance of the image V. This is distance of the object and the distance of the image V. Then M is equal to distance of the image divided by distance of the object, that means V by U. If the magnification is greater than 1, then we get an enlarged image. Students, now let's see the important formula, lens maker's formula. All lenses are made up of transparent materials, that you also know. Any optically transparent material will have a refractive index. The lens formula relates the focal length of the lens with the distance of object and the image. For a maker of any lens, usually the optical stores develop some lenses for the requirement of the customers. knowledge of radii of curvature of the lens is required. This clearly indicates that the need for an equation which is related to the radii of curvature of the lens, the refractive index of the given material of the lens, and the required focal length of the lens. So, the lens maker's formula is one such equation, and it is given as 1 by f is equal to mu minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Let's see what are the abbreviations of mu, r, and f. Here, mu is the refractive index of the material of the lens. R1 is the and R2 are the radii of curvature of the two faces of the lens. F is the focal length of the lens. Remember, the lens maker formula and the lens are applicable to only thin lenses. In the case of thick lenses, this lens maker's formula will need little modification to use. Now, power of a lens. What do you mean by this power of a lens? We all know. We need to know about the power of each and everything in the world. Like that, in the lens, when a ray of light falls on a lens, the ability to converge or the ability to diverge the light rays are depends upon the focal length of the lens. Now, this ability of a lens to converge using the convex lens or diverge through a concave lens is called its power. The power of a lens can be defined as the degree of convergence or divergence of light rays. Power of a lens is numerically defined as the reciprocal of its focal length. You can see this shows about the power P is equal to 1 by F, and this shows how it is measured. This picture shows you the SI unit of power of a lens is diopter, and it is represented by the symbol D. If focal length is measured in M, then the power of a lens is expressed in D, and 1D is the power of a lens whose focal length is 1 meter, then 1D is equal to 1M minus 1. This shows the power of a lens to converge or to diverge an image. Let's see what are the differences between convex lens and concave lens. Convex lens is a thicker in the middle than the edges. Concave lens is thinner in the middle than the edges. Convex lens is a converging lens, while the concave lens is a diverging lens. The convex lens produces mostly real images, but the concave lens produces virtual images. Convex lens is used to treat hypermetropia, and concave lens is used to treat myopia. Thank you, students. Thank you very much.